and gentlemen, and as always, thank you for watching. Today we've been called by one of our local customers that has a tanker loaded with sugar water that, as you can see, we've had a lot of rain. The ground is soft, and apparently the dolly legs fell through the soft ground. They need it lifted up, the nose lifted up and moved forward a little bit, so we're going to go see what we can do. Nosedive trailer. See what they want us to do here. This is what's called a keyhole adapter. It's used on the fifth wheels when, like in this case, there isn't enough room. To get fifth wheel plate or the fifth wheel adapter under it. Grade 100s. All right, got a wood block under the nose because I'm gonna have to be under it. I don't have any other option. We talked about setting off to the side and lifting the tank and having them back a tractor under it. They wanted to try it this way first because the ground is really, really soft. Putting this together out here so I don't have to be under the trailer any longer than I have to be. This way I can leave the chains laying out. Hook this underneath it and carry on. All
You aren't sure that block's under there good. Used a single chain, that big long one, but this will be all right. Thank you. just use the underreach as a brace. And that's it. It'll come up with the wheel lift, or with the boom. Thank you. to go up just a little more. Perfect on the pad. Man. Oh, with the brakes set, all I gotta do is take my underreach back and use the boom to raise it, and then we can lower the dollies. That ain't no big deal. Not a problem at all. The worst part's over. Getting it up out of the hole and getting it moved. Even that bar's got an arch in it though.
It does, that's right.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either, buddy.
Yeah.
I don't know either.
We'll find out.
We will. Don't need that anymore. No, he had it in there.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, it worked out perfect.
Going through that box out back.
It worked out perfectly.
Yeah.
I don't like the edge of those chains running over the edge, but at least it's not super sharp.
Right.
Normally I'd put wood cribbing in there, but it's so dang heavy, it'd bust right through it. Thank you. I got it, Dennis. Go ahead, buddy. Still needs to go up a little bit, doesn't it?
Looks like it.
Well, that shows to be about where the marks usually set on it. You can see the paint.
Yeah.
I'll leave it just a little bit high. They can always drop it down. They can't come up. Just gonna let it sit there for a minute. I don't like the way that's bent. Would you care to go see if Frankie's got a truck that he can stick under this? Just to be safe, because that leg over here is folding in a little bit. Right there, you can see it, get a decent look at the keyhole and how it locks in. This is not ideal by any means, but it worked. Oh. Nothing like starting out the day getting all hot and sweaty and nasty. Today starts a week-long excessive heat warning. The only thing I'm concerned about is the way that cross beam is bowed.
Yeah.
And I don't want those legs to, or especially this one, to fold in.
Yep.
If you've got a tractor that you can slide under it real quick, have it ready and aired up, and I'll drop out real quick and pull out from under it and you put a tractor under it.
Okay.
Hopefully, I don't think it's going to go anywhere, but if it sits here very long, it could. It just runs that risk, you know.
Yeah.
I'd rather not, if we can keep from it.
Yeah, that's sort of. No.
It's been in a little bit.
Yeah.
If it wasn't loaded, it wouldn't be any big deal, you know. But loaded with liquid, I'd rather be safe than sorry.
Yeah. Yeah. Makes that thing up the field.
It broke the bottom ring on that other one too.
Probably cut that cross member loose. Picked up. It's liable to go back place a little bit. You know.
Uh-huh.
Maybe. Yeah, I'll put a truck under it. I got one over here. I'll go ahead and get there.
All right, buddy. Yep. I'd feel safer about that, wouldn't you?
Yeah. I don't want to lose the mounter.
No, we've done got her up. Let's keep it that way. I'll change this stuff back around when I get back to the shop.
content yet.
Yeah.
I've only got 20 subscribers.
What are you trying to work on though? What's your theme or whatever?
My theme is I'm going to get my CDL here soon.
Okay.
To drive semis, and
yeah.
That's what my channel is going to be about.
Oh, okay, cool.
Over the road life and stuff.
Yep. It's a different world out there.
Oh yeah. Well, I gotta find a way to make some money to support my fiance and my newborn child that we just had.
You betcha. You betcha. Stand back. I'm gonna let her down. Just real nice and easy. Get hooked up to it. Whew. It warmed up already. This way, yes sir, this way. Dump your airbags. Raise your airbags up. Wonderful. That makes it feel a whole lot better.
Better, huh?
That's a lot better.
Yep. I gotta take that truck and chop too.
You'll grab one end of this, I'll have to carry it back in. out, Hess.
I thought I was on the scissors on the roll off when I raised
my Yeah. Yep.
For safety.
All right, Frankie. Thanks, sir.
Yep, appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Anytime. Anytime. I think I know what you're talking about, but no, all of my stuff is like those chains are the 5/8 grade 100 overhead rate, yeah, rated lifting capacity. They've got to be the grade 100 certified for overhead lifting. Got the tag, ID tags with the working load limits and everything on them.
Fact, remember so often.
And them son of guns are heavy and they're expensive.
I know. We had some on frame machine down there that was heavy, and then they had some of them others like I was talking about.
Right.
Shoot, they were different daylight and dark.
I tell you what though, some of the endless loop slings, the synthetic slings that we've got,
yeah,
are just as strong or stronger and a whole lot lighter, but they don't handle going over rough edges like that. You know, it would have cut a strap just like that if I'd have tried to go over that sharp edge with it like I did there.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you know, one of those synthetic slings, shoot, you can handle them like nothing.
Yeah. A bunch of them got hooks on them too now, don't they?
I mean, some of them, yeah. You can put hooks on them too, just with a shackle and a attachable hook. No big deal.
Some places are a lot better, aren't they?
Yeah.
Keep them.
Oh yeah, they're.
Can.
The slings have got, slings are really, really a lot better in some instances, but you know, everything's got its place. You know, yeah, everything's got a place. That wasn't a sling job unless you're going to lift the tank off the side of the tank, you know.
Yeah.
And then you wrap your big recovery slings around the belly and up the sides to lift it. Then you use slings instead of chains so that you spread the weight out.
Yeah. Like it, yeah,
but there they're not going over a sharp surface, so you don't worry about cutting them.
Yep.
Which was our other option that we talked about. That's what I would have done. I'd use a couple of 12 inch wide recovery straps to spread the weight out on them. Probably run them across the ribs.
I didn't really have any problem lifting it, as far as that part is.
No, lifting
just
it's not
getting a hold of it the way you wanted to get it.
Yeah, getting a hold of it safely without tearing anything up. And then moving with a loaded trailer behind one of these is...
Could be dangerous, couldn't it?
It can. It puts you really, really light on your front end.
Well, thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Like I told him, I'll just finish up back over the shop. All right. Well, best of luck to you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, there she sits, hooked up to a tractor safely. As always, thank you for watching and God bless.